Chris Weisz is better known for his blockbuster movies American Pie, The Golden Compass, Ants, and the Twilight saga New Moon, among others.
Actor, director, producer, Chris Weisz, what are you more out of those three things?
I'm director, most of all, because, I mean, that's where you get to have the biggest effect. You can take a script and have a little to do with everything. And with a movie as important to me as A Better Life, it's very important that I can make sure that we get all the details right. Because on one level, it's the story of a father and a son, but it's also the story of an immigrant without papers and his natural-born son. And so we're dealing with very, very complicated and important issues, and we wanted to get everything correct.
And you're immediately connected to this cause, so to speak.
Cool. Yeah.
How so?
Well, you know, it's been a fascinating process, because the original reason I wanted to do it was just because it was very, very well written. But there was some connection, because my grandmother is Mexican-born. She lives in this country. But my grandmother came here when she was 17 in order to be in silent films. And she was also a star of Mexico's first talking picture, Santa. And she's 101 now. And she's always been a big source of inspiration and wisdom for me. You know, that I should save money, that I should work hard, you know, that I should be sober and decent and honest and all those things. And then she also said, we were saying before, that you should buy stock in beer companies in the summer, because people drink beer in the summer. So she's
true.
An investment advisor as well. My father was a refugee from Nazi Germany. So like a lot of Americans, you know, I didn't arrive on the Mayflower. My family didn't. And the more that we worked on this movie, the more I had to get to know what I was talking about. So the more I met gardeners and ex-gang members, people in the community in East Los Angeles, and the more I learn, the more sympathy I have.
How does Hollywood take this? Because now all of a sudden you're a great name, you're a huge name, celebrity in Hollywood, and all of a sudden you're a slash activist too, and you chose this cause, none other than illegal immigrants, or legal immigrants as well, but it's still immigration to them.
Yeah, I think that, you know, for the most part, Hollywood doesn't pay attention. And that's in spite of the fact that all the places that they're going to eat and have their important meetings, who's filling up the water, who's cooking the food in back.
Do you also hire Latinos? Do you identify the power of Latinos also in your industry?
Yeah, I mean, there's a tremendous pool of talent in Los Angeles. You know, another unfortunate thing is that a lot of movies now get made in Canada or in other countries, because they offer incentives to go there. But one of the great things about A Better Life is that we were able to shoot it here in Los Angeles, which is, I've only shot two movies in Los Angeles out of the six that I've made. My very first one, American Pie, and A Better Life. Now, I was very intent that we hire a bilingual crew for A Better Life, because I thought it was respectful of the communities we're going to be going into. And it's not like we had to you know, make any allowances. They're incredibly talented Latino craftspeople here in Los Angeles and in America in general.
Mm-hmm. Where do you take it from here? What is your next project? Are you thinking about this same cause? Are you thinking about huge title, blockbuster? What are you planning?
I'm not thinking about blockbusters, and I usually just wait around until the next movie that I feel like I have to make. But for now, actually, this movie, the issues of this movie are so important to me that for a while I'm going to concentrate on that. I think that there's some very important things happening with regards to immigration in this country. There's a lot of misinformation, there's a lot of hatred, but there are also a lot of people who are honestly trying to make things better. And so I would like to use this movie as a way to teach people about the issues. And I'm going to be more of an activist. This movie has actually made me a kind of a political person in a way that I wasn't before. So, you know, I was just at the Congressional Hispanic Caucus recently. And they gave an award to the film, which was fantastic. And we realized that the film can be a great way to teach people about the issues surrounding immigration, why we need immigration reform.